بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. My dear brothers and sisters, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. Welcome to Roadmap to a Successful Ramadan, point number 6, befriend the successful. We mentioned in the previous session and previous message to you that studying the life of the successful is very, very important. As a matter of fact, successful people, they love to imitate and they love to adapt the tradition and the customs of a successful one as well. Now for you to achieve that, you need also to befriend the successful. It is very important not just to read about successful people in books, you need to have them in your life. Now how can you do that unless you be around those who are successful in their lives? They don't have to be the greatest role model to you, but at least they can assist you to become good friends, inshallah ta'ala, successful ones who will assist you in succeeding in Ramadan and in your life in, overall. You know, in the Arabic language, we say as-sahib sahib, which means friend. A friend gravitates, means pulls towards him or towards her. So it depends on who's your companion, I can tell you who you are. Depends on who's the person that you hang out with, I can predict your qualities and your characteristics. So if you're hanging out with successful people, most likely you'll be a successful one as well. Now when it comes to the month of Ramadan in particular, you need to find someone who is willing to succeed, and he is actually or she is going and working on succeeding in the month of Ramadan. They say that habits are contagious, meaning if you go around good people again, you are going to adapt their tradition, their customs, whether you like it or not. Being around them for so long, you're going to become one of them. There's even a statement in the English language that says, if you can't beat them, join them. Now that means eventually, under pressure, you will find yourself just following the same tradition and customs of those people. Accompany the good people, accompany the successful ones. It's very important for you in this dunya and in the akhirah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is warning us against having the wrong company. قال الله تبارك وتعالى ويوم يعض الظالم على يديه يقول يا ليتني اتخذت مع الرسول سبيلا يا ويلتا ليتني لم اتخذ فلانا خليلا. That on the day of judgment, that day means the wrongdoer will be biting on his or her fingers and their hands, wishing that they have taken a path or a way or followed the Rasul, the Messenger of Allah. They will say, Ya waylata laytani lam attakhud fulanan khalila. I wish that I haven't taken such as a friend. Why? Because they know that they have misled them in this life. In Ramadan, look for those who can help you and assist you to achieve, inshallah ta'ala, successful month of Ramadan. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, مَثَلُ الْجَلِيسِ الصَّالِحِ وَالْجَلِيسِ السُّءِ كَحَامِلِ الْمِسْكِ وَنَافِخِ الْكِيرِ. The example of the righteous friend and the non-righteous friends is just like the example of حامل المسك, the perfume seller or merchant, and نافخ الكير, the blacksmith. Now نافخ حامل المسك, the one who sells perfume, when you go into a perfume store, he said صلى الله عليه وسلم إما أن يحذيك وإما أن تبتاع منه وإما أن تجد منه ريحا طيبة. You whether get something for free, you get a sample for free, or you're gonna buy something from them, or at least if you get nothing, you just have a beautiful and nice fragrance and smell you get from there. So this is exactly the good friend. This good friend, he might or she might go look after you. So eventually they give you an advice without you soliciting that. They just give it to you because they care about you. Or when you need their advice, you go and you ask them and they give it to you and they offer it to you. If you didn't get any of these, if you weren't in need of any advice, the least thing you could get from them is when you're around them, you feel comfortable, you feel safe, and you feel, you know, in good company, in safe hands. Now the second example, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned, قال and the bad company is the example of the blacksmith. إما يحرق ثيابك أو تجد منه ريحا خبيثة. When they blow into the fire, sparks all over the place. Most likely, it's going to burn your clothes, or would leave you with bad smell. So when you walk around the people, they will say, "What is the smell?" And they sense that from you. So eventually, being around those people gonna perhaps give that wrong impression about you. If you would like to succeed, you need to study the life of the successful and befriend the successful ones. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.